You require my services? You have my thanks. Here's how it goes. Torres meets with Prince, carrying a portion of the ransom, saying the rest is close behind. When we see the Sage, you bring in the rest of the gold, make the swap, and get out. I'll be watching all from close by.
No, Kemmer, you run this scheme alone, at the risk of losing the faith of your crew. It makes me ill to think of you bartering with that wretched slaver.
Come on, mate. Once we have the Sage, we'll all be rich.
Not if young Master Kid gets to him first.
Kid? Jesus. That lad's here to kill him.
Edward, what the hell are you doing here?
I'm tailing these men to the Sage. Can you hold off till he appears?
The Sage? All right, Jesus. I'll stay in my room for a time, but not long.
How long has it been since our last meeting, Senor Prince? A year?
Near 18 months. You first described this Roberts fellow to me in November of 1715.
Ah, I see. Much has changed in that short time, you know. None called me governor, for instance, for I quit that post last year.
Ah, I was not aware.
You couldn't help it, could you, Kemmer? Sticking your nose at things you can't understand.
You're making me nervous, kid. Keep your blades corked.
So many churches in peace.
Just my bloody...
Had the English at last taken to converting their slaves.
And I'm kept in killing them both. Ah!
Steady, Jim. We're close. Don't worry.
God knows, Torres. There's none here so foolish as them.
Foolish? How do you mean?
Is it not a sin to enslave a fellow Christian? Therefore, to transmute a slave's soul from animal to man would be tantamount to inviting one's cattle to the dinner table.
Forgive my impression, but how far is it?
We are nearly there.
You've no reason to be slipping about here.
Stand your ground, slave, and face corporal punishment like a man.
Why act like a man now, when you have denied me that right for 30 years?
Find your bearing apologies. I believe all thinking, feeling men deserve respect and opportunity.
Ah, you Spaniards. Your long ties to the Moors have diluted your blood and softened your hearts.
This is not to say I believe in the natural equality of all races or sexes. Truly men with talent and intelligence should be. But there is no true profit to be gained by the practice of slavery. In the short term, it makes us money, see. But in the long term, it will render us the victims of our own success.
Ah, but you and I, sir, old as we are, will not live to see that unfortunate day. Oh, I fall.
for virtue.
If nothing else.
Virtue? Oh, Torres. I have no wish to waste my day chattering about slaves and their pitiable condition. Let us conclude this transaction, then celebrate.
For virtue,
if nothing else.
Virtue? Oh, Torres. I have no wish to waste my day chattering about slaves and their pitiable condition. Let us conclude this transaction, then celebrate as friends. Other stories about you, Cruiser.
See. I am one of a number of civil servants in my family.
Gotta get away from. I'll teach you myself. Only I feel I have too much money.
Sack Panama. 1671, was it?
Other stories about you, Trusha. You were a governor in Florida for a time. Other stories about you, Trusha. You were a governor in Florida for a time.
See. I am one of a number of civil servants in my family. A long line of politicians.
I have always toyed with the idea of entering politics myself. Only I feel I have too much money and not enough years.
Speaking of stories, Prince, I've heard it said you were with Henry Morgan the day he sacked Panama. 1671, was it?
Oh, it's all true, yes. But let us not overesteem the honors forged and won on the battlefield. That skirmish was a deadly one, and a tremendous waste of coin and resources. It wasn't until many years after that I sheathed my sword in favor of a far safer and yet more profitable venture. Capital, Henry Cook. Honor bought is more enjoyable than honor won, if a touch less permanent.
Hey, get out here, Shrubber!
Other stories about you, Trusha. You were a governor in Florida for a time.
Si. I am one of a number of civil servants in my family, a long line of politicians.
I have always toyed with the idea of entering politics myself. Only I feel I have too much money and not enough years.
You should be more.
There's your reason.
I've always toyed with the idea of entering politics myself. Only I feel I have too much money and not enough years.
Speaking of stories, Prince, I've heard it said you were with Henry Morgan the day he sacked Panama. 1671, was it?
Oh, it's all true, yes. But let us not overesteem the honors forged and won on the battlefield. That skirmish was a deadly one, and a tremendous waste of coin and resources. It wasn't until other stories about you, Trusha. You were a governor in Florida for a time.
Si. I am one of a number of civil servants in my family, a long line of politicians.
I have always toyed with the idea of entering politics myself. Only I feel I have too much money and not enough years.
Speaking of stories, Prince, I've heard it said you were with Henry Morgan the day he sacked Panama. 1671, was it?
Oh, it's all true, yes. But let us not overesteem the honors forged and won on the battlefield. That skirmish was a deadly one, and a tremendous waste of coin and resources. It wasn't until many years after that I sheathed my sword in favor of a far safer and yet profitable venture. Capital and resources. That's where money is made. And sir, let me tell you, honor bought is more enjoyable than honor won, if a touch less permanent. You say you came alone, Taurus?
Not alone, but certainly without colleagues. I took passage aboard a British merchant's brig.
Ah.
Now's the time.
No. Not until we see the sage.
Here's a quiet spot. I'll see the money.
This is a portion of the ransom. The rest is close at hand.
It pains me to traffic someone of my own race for profit, Mr. Taurus. Tell me again, what has this Roberts fellow done to upset you?
is some form of Protestant piety I'm not familiar with.
Perhaps another day.
What?
Next time, see to it that we are not followed. Deal with this!
You cocked up my kill getaway!
For a better cause!
No! Jim, stop!
Not this time, Kimway.
Come on, man! We can work this together!
You had your chance.
Stay your blade, kid! Wait! Jim, stop!
Get up! Get out of here! Air! Come to me!
Keep your nutty hands off me!
I can't let you kill those men, kid. Not until I found the Sage.
I've been stalking that pig for a week now, charting his moves, and here I find not one but two of my targets, and you rob me of both.
Patience, man. You'll have your kills.
When I locate the Sage, you're helping me take Prince. Got that!
My wife's inheritance was not inconsiderable, nor unkind in its attribution. I only pray their rude health persists in these feeble times.
Good day and fortune favor you.
Now you're making sense. Here's the rub.
Thank you.
Wouldn't you prefer meeting in a pub?
I came to Kingston chasing a target. Getting pissed ain't a priority.
We could work together on this, you know. It's Lawrence Prince you're after. I want his prisoner.
We're after the Sage as well, Edward. Careful who you cross.
May the best man win.
There's guards patrolling that property from end to end. Looks to me like they use bells to signal trouble. See there? We'll want to disable those before pushing too far. With so many men about, we can't rely on stealth alone, so I'll do what I can to distract and draw their attention, giving you a chance to cut them down. Ready?
Your name's not James, is it?
Not most days. Come on. If you see Prinz before I do, kill him, and there'll be a bit of coin in it for you. All right?
Man. How is it you're a woman?
Christ, Edward. Is that something that needs explaining?
Even that Spanish fella meant to come up here.
Now, I'm here to do a job. I'll let you be amused later.
Hear what happened? He was attacked by a couple of brigands on his way here. Buccaneers or the like. A nasty business.
Jesus. You're right.
Slipped away from what I heard. Prince ain't too happy neither.
Stop there.
Thank you. Thank you. interloper! Raise the alarm!
The alarm's been disrupted.
You!
Thank you.
Both! Stand your ground!
Please, I've been shot. I need aid.
Christ, Thompson, look at her. She's hurt.
Dreadfully, sir. I'm poorly.
All right.
I'm faint.
Take an arm, lass.
Bless you, lass.
For you, then. You are the most inarticulate bugger I've ever met.
Oi, man. That ain't.
Thank you.
eye hang over me like a leering crow to see an old man suffer?
You've caused no small portion of suffering yourself, Mr. Prince. Retribution, I suppose.
You absurd cutthroats and your precious philosophy. You live in the world, but you cannot make it move.
You mistake my motive, old man. I'm only after a bit of coin.
As was I, lad. As was I.
Heads up, Kenway! I found your man!
I remember you. The Templar from Havana.
I'm no Templar, mate. That was just a ruse. We've come here to save your ass from this slaver.
Save me? I work for Mr. Prince.
Well, then he's a poor man to call master. He meant to sell you out to the Templars.
Oh, you can't trust anyone, it seems.
Roberts!
Bastards in my sights! I've got a dead line on him!
I've got a clear
ready
shot!
Ready to take the shot!
He's dead in my sights! Trying to give us the slip, maggot!
Lost your man again, did you?
Aye. Roberts is a devil with a queer aversion to kindness. I suppose that's two men I've lost today. So, what's your real name, lass?
Mary Reed to my mum. And them I call friends. But not a word of it to anyone. Or I'll unman you as well.